knew that I would not. So good, so good, I got a year. Oh, I feel nice. A sugar and spice.
Come on,
I feel nice. A sugar and spice.
Get your dad so song nice. With me because this so is nice. The opening to pleasure. Hello, 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 hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live tapping experience. What a joy, what an honor it is to be here with everyone tonight. The live tapping experience. This is the first time we are making this particular live class open to the whole public. We've had it in our community for a while, and now we are sharing it here with you today. So I'm so excited. This is the first time we're doing it with this extended community. Emma! Hey, sister! Beautiful. So, little lay of the land. If you want to turn your video on and tap and show everyone how powerful you are when you clear your emotions and let everyone know that it's okay to feel and it's okay to be seen, then I encourage you to turn your video on. If you don't want to keep your video on at any point, you can always turn it off during the live class. We're going to do a few things. We're going to open up, do a little breath work, set an intention together. After we've set an intention, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. We're going to talk a little bit about what we're going to tap on, which I'm really excited about this topic tonight, which is all about self-love and pleasure. After the tapping session, we're going to do a little bit of laughter tapping. And if you are new to my work, you probably have never experienced laughter tapping before. Basically, we just give ourselves permission to laugh for absolutely no reason. When we do that, we activate the pathways in the brain. We also activate all of the happy chemicals as well. And we flood our system with all of that beautiful serotonin, the endorphins, all of those good chemicals right at the end. We'll close out with a meditation, do some feedback at the end, learn about what you all experienced, and that will be our night. So before we jump in, head on over to the chat area. I would love to hear from you. Where in the world are you coming in from? And tell me, what would you like to bring pleasure to in your life? Now, as you think about that question, pleasure, sometimes you might be like, well, it's just sexual. No, pleasure is a feeling of feeling good in your body, in your life, feeling happy, enjoying your life. Where do you want to bring more of that joy? Where do you want to bring more of that happiness? Where do you want more ease and relaxation and ultimately pleasure? Go ahead and write that in the chat box as well. Awesome. What have we got here? Vermont, Washington State, Kansas, Perth, Western Australia. Yay, my hometown. San Francisco, some Australia, Atlanta, pleasure in career and work. Beautiful. Burlington, nice. Las Vegas, Toronto, Los Angeles. Beautiful. Okay. So here's the deal with pleasure. I want to give you a little rundown on what's been going on in my life and why this topic is so freaking important. Last year, I did life like a complete flip of what I'm doing right now in my life. I overworked myself. I put my pleasure as second. I put my goals as first. And as a result, I ran myself into the ground. And my energy started to wane, my health started to suffer, and I had a wake-up call. And I was like, wow, like if it was my last day on planet Earth, wouldn't I want to be enjoying my days? And yes, I have a mission that I want to fulfill, but do I need to sacrifice my pleasure in order to achieve my mission? And then I got thinking about it and I realized something that was very interesting. So whatever it is that you want to bring pleasure to in your life, I realized that from a very young age, we all turn off pleasure at certain degrees. And the reason why we do that is because so much of the time we think it's protecting us to turn off our pleasure. Here's an example. You get really hurt in the love of your life relationship. You just dived in, your heart was blasted open. You felt so much love. You were head over heels. You had never felt so much pleasure, so much joy in your life. Then you have a crash in that relationship. And after that, you shut your heart down and the next person comes along and you don't open your heart up as much. You're blocking the level of pleasure that can come into your life as a result, because you're trying to protect yourself from being hurt. When we try to protect ourselves from something, that's when we often block the pleasure. There's other areas that we might block pleasure as well. For example, the example that I said about really working really hard. When I work really hard, then I'll get the pleasure. Or when I make X amount of money, then I can have the pleasure. Or when I convince those people to like me, then I'll have the pleasure. And we're constantly putting this beautiful feeling off. And it relates very deeply to self-love, because I believe when we really love ourselves on a very deep level, then we allow ourselves to have pleasure in every moment. Things are going to change in our environment, but it doesn't mean we need to contract. It means we just create more pleasure wherever we are. So that's what we're going to do tonight. I hope that you guys are excited. Beautiful. Hi, Kelsey. Good to see you again. Passion, long time depression. Okay. Imperial Valley, ancestral and childhood wounds. We've got some really deep stuff we're going to work on tonight. So we're going to go from like really painful stuff and we are going to flip it. But before we flip it, we've got to hold it in all of our love. So to start with, I want you to turn off any distractions. Give yourself this next hour where you can really dive deep with me, where you can really be with those wounds, where you can really process. If you've got any distractions, close your door, grab a journal, grab a glass of water, some tissues, there may be some tears, you never know. Get yourself comfortable because we are about to start. Beautiful. Awesome. All right. So as we take this moment right now, as we settle into our own energy, I want you just to close your eyes. And as you close your eyes, I want you to bring your energy into this space right here, right now. This space with your body. This space with your own energy. Feel yourself let go of the day right now. Feel yourself arrive in the moment. Feel your spine aligned and straight. Now bring your arms up to the sides and plug your fingers in to the palms and point the thumbs towards the middle. And if you're on your cycle, women, just long, deep breaths here. For everyone else, we're going to move into a breath of fire. And the way that we do that is we pump the belly. So on the exhale, we bring the belly towards the spine. So to start with, just stick out your tongue just to practice and start panting like a dog like this. Beautiful. You all look so dashing. And now close your mouth and do that through your nose. So you're pumping the belly right now and you're rotating that breath through your system. Close your eyes as you do this. Clearing the energy right now. clearing out anything that doesn't serve you so that you can align to your intention. Keep going. We have 20 more seconds of this. And inhale, hold the breath. Join the thumbs together over your head. Keep the breath held. Stretch the fingers up tall so they're facing towards the sky. Take a little bit more breath in, hold that breath. And then like a cannonball out of your mouth, I want you to blow all the air out of your body and bring your hands down to your knees. Closing your eyes for a moment. Tuning into this intention right now. Tuning into your own divine nature. Calling in a full transformation, a quantum leap in energy, a quantum leap in self-expression, a radical transformation, a surrendering and an opening into our greatest expression, to recognize and remember the gift of pleasure in our life, to love ourselves, to heal, to transform, and to step powerfully into a new way that serves our life and our highest potential. Take a long, deep breath into this intention. Hold the breath. Exhale slowly. As we hold that intention now, we're going to start massaging underneath the collarbone here. And we're going to give ourselves permission tonight to feel whatever emotions are there. To give ourselves permission to be messy, to give ourselves permission to be angry, to be violent, to be sad, to be depressed, to be angry, to be jealous, to be overwhelmed, to be whatever is there inside our system, knowing that we will lovingly hold it in compassion so that it can finally heal. So in this moment, we give ourselves full permission to feel it all. Whatever has been coming up in your life, it has permission to be here tonight. And then repeating after me, tapping the center of the chest. I've been disconnected from my own pleasure by, and tell me what's happening in your life and how you're feeling disconnected. Tapping between the brows. I've really been struggling with, tell me what area you've been struggling with. Tapping the temples. I've been really struggling with, tell me again what that is. And I give myself permission to be with it tonight. Tapping the cheeks. I give myself permission to be with what? Tell me what it is. Even though it's been making me feel what? What has it been making you feel in your life? Has it been making you feel stuck, sad, depressed, scared, fearful, resistant, overwhelmed? What's it been making you feel? It's been making me feel, tell me the three most limiting emotions that come up when it's mostly triggered. Tapping underneath the lips. It's been making me feel, tell me what it's been making you feel. And that is totally understandable. Tapping the center of the chest. I've been so disconnected from pleasure here. Tapping the front of the ribs. I've been feeling really, tell me what you've been feeling. Tapping the side of the ribs, about, tell me what it's about again. Describe the challenge, describe the block, describe what's been coming up for you. About. Tapping the side of the wrist. And what have you been thinking as well? I've been thinking, have you been thinking, I'm not good enough, I'm not worthy, my needs don't matter, it's too hard, they're going to judge me. What are you thinking? What are the thoughts that are going on in your mind? I've been thinking. Tapping the side of the thumb. And that makes me feel what? That makes me feel. Tapping the next finger, and it's understandable. I have been struggling. Tapping the next finger, it's understandable. I feel stuck here. Tapping the opposite side of the next finger, it's understandable. I haven't been feeling safe here. Tapping the little finger, but I'm in a safe place to look at it now. I'm in a safe place to look at this right now. Tapping the side of the hand, and I'm forgiving myself for how hard it has been. Just feel that right now. Feel into any way that you've been really hard on yourself about this, any way that you've been blaming or shaming yourself or putting yourself down or thinking you're not good enough or comparing yourself to others. Feel that right now. Feel how you've been putting yourself down. And just send yourself some compassion right now and some forgiveness. You've just been doing the best you know how. Tapping the top of the head, it's possible I'm worthy of forgiveness here. Tapping between the brows, I am worthy of forgiveness here. Tapping the temples, I am worthy of love here. Tapping the cheeks, and I'm in a safe place to heal this. Feel into any resistance to looking at it. Feel into any resistance to feeling it, any avoidance that's been coming up for you. Any trying to numb it, any trying to push it away, not look at it, pretend everything's okay. Just feel that tendency to put on a happy face when you're not really feeling it. And just hold that part of you in love right now and understanding you're just doing your best. Feel that right now, right there, right there. You're safe to feel that right now. Hold it in your love, your presence, right there. It's safe right now. And lean into it a little bit more and take a long, deep breath into that place and open it up with your breath. Inhale. Exhale, release the sigh. Tapping underneath the nose. I'm in a safe place to finally look at this. Tapping underneath the lips. I'm in a safe place to finally look at what? Tell me what that is. And speak it out loud if you can, if you're in a quiet space. The more you vocalize it, the more you light up the pathways in your brain. Wow, we just had a power outage in Costa Rica. Back on. Take a big, deep breath into that. Release a big sigh. Got some real power there. You guys shut off my power over here. Tapping the center of the chest. I'm in a safe place to finally look at this. Tapping the front of the ribs. I give myself permission to be with this right now. Tapping the side of the ribs. I give myself permission to be with what? Tell me what it is. What is the struggle? What is the disconnection? What is the fear? What is the block? Tell me what it is. I give myself permission to be with, tell me what that is. Tapping the side of the wrist, and I am in a safe place. And I'm ready to finally heal this. Tapping the side of the thumb. I am ready to finally heal this. Tapping the next finger. And I don't care how many generations it's been in my family line. Tapping the next finger. I don't care how many of my ancestors passed it down to me. I am ready to heal this. And I can look at it with open eyes. Take a long, deep breath into it right there. Release a big sigh. Oh, beautiful. Tapping the opposite side of the next finger. Are you ready to look at this more deeply? Okay. So I want you to tune into how it's been feeling in your body. How this lack of pleasure, this disconnection, this fear, this overwhelm, this worry, this concern, this heaviness, this disconnection from those around you, the issue that's been coming up. Feel how that feels in your body. What is the texture of it? And on a scale of 0 to 10, how intense is it? 10 being it's so uncomfortable. 0 being you're in absolute pleasure. And go ahead and just write that number in the chat area and then come back to chatting with me. And then tapping the little finger. even though it's a, and tell me the number, I can heal this. Tapping the side of the hand, I can let go of this. And I'm ready to give it a shot. Okay, give me a thumbs up if you're ready to give it a shot. You guys want to go there with me? Okay, great. So as you tune into that texture, you tune into that energy that's in your body, you tune into that struggle, I want you to just close your eyes right now and tune into the earliest memory that pops into your mind right now where you remember feeling a similar way. And the first memory that pops up is the right memory to go to. Not all of us can go way back to childhood. The more you tap, the more access you get to those earlier memories. But whatever pops up first, we'll start with, okay? Tapping the top of the head. This reminds me of, and just go on a rant, tell me what that earlier memory is for you. This reminds me of, I was, and just tell me the story. Who was involved? What was taking place? What were people doing? How did that affect you? I want you to tell me as if you're telling a story right now. Well, this happened and I was this old and they said this to me and then I shut down or then they abandoned me or whatever it was. Tell me what was going on. Tapping between the brows. And that made me feel what? What did that make you feel when that happened in that memory? That made me feel tapping the temples. That made me feel, what did that situation make you feel? Tapping the cheeks. And I started believing what? What did you start believing about yourself or about reality as a result of that happening? I started believing, tell me what that is. And when you started believing that, what was the most intense emotion that was backed up by it? And that made me feel tapping underneath the lips. And I've been thinking and feeling that for a really long time. Tapping the center of the chest. Because I wasn't getting the love, support, or safety that I needed. And what was the most painful part of that memory for you? What was the most painful part? If you could go frame by frame and find the most painful part in that memory, what was it? The most painful part was, tell me what that is. Tapping the front of the ribs. That really sucked. That made me shut off my pleasure immediately. That made me shut down. And what did that make you do when that happened? Did you retract? Did you get defensive and aggressive? Did you hide? Did you freeze? Did you start doubting yourself? What happened? I started to, and say it out loud, I started to tapping the side of the ribs, and I've been doing that ever since. I've been and what's your protection mechanism that you've been doing ever since that thing happened? I've been, tell me what your protection mechanism is. Tapping the side of the wrist. I have been, tell me what you've been doing ever since. Tapping the side of the thumb. Just trying to protect myself. I have been, tell me what you've been doing. Just trying to protect myself. Tapping the next finger, but I still don't feel safe. Tapping the opposite side of the next finger. I still don't feel love. I still don't feel what? What do you want to feel? I still don't feel. Tapping the little finger. Because what I really needed in that situation was what? What did you need in that memory that would have helped you? I really needed what? What did you need that you did not get? Tapping the side of the hand. I really needed, tell me again what you needed. And I want you to be real with yourself. This might be the first time you've ever admitted to yourself that, hey, actually, I probably needed that. And guess what? You are also worthy of it. I am worthy of, tell me what you are worthy of. Tapping the top of the head. I am worthy of. Tapping between the brows, even though they didn't give it to me. Tapping the temples, it's possible I have always been worthy of what? Tell me what that is. Tapping the cheeks, and I forgive myself for thinking that I wasn't worthy. Tapping underneath the nose, I am worthy of. Tell me what you are worthy of. Tapping underneath the lips, I am worthy of what? I want you to really feel it in every vibrating cell of your body right now. When you say it, I want you to believe it. I am worthy of what? Tapping the center of the chest. I am worthy of. I want you to vocalize it. I want you to feel it. I want you to know it. I am worthy of. I am worthy of. And I've been worthy this whole time. And I don't have to wait any longer. Tapping the front of the ribs. I don't need to convince anybody to give it to me. And I don't have to prove myself. I am worthy of. Tell me what you are worthy of. tapping the side of the ribs, and I am worthy of that right now. And I am making up for lost time. Take a big, deep breath in, release a big, deep sigh. Ah. I'm ready to receive what? Tapping the side of the wrist. What are you ready to receive? Tapping the side of the thumb, and I can receive it now. Take another big, deep breath in, release a big sigh. Beautiful, tapping the next finger. Are you ready to really let yourself receive that now? Are you ready to open up your life and say, okay, it is time? Beautiful. So let's do this together. Let's allow ourselves to fully receive it now. Tapping the next finger. I want you to tune into wherever in that earlier memory you felt disconnected, hurt, let down. I want you to tune into that freeze frame where you felt like my needs don't matter, all hope is lost, I'm not worthy, what's the point? I want you to tune into that right now. And as you see that in your memory right now, and I want you to see that in that earlier version of you, I want you to feel it in your body, the innocent pain that's there. And I want you to tune into how painful that felt in your body. And as you tune into that, I want you to imagine you're opening your eyes in that memory, in that pain, in that sorrow, in that fear, in that disconnection, in that doubt, in that anger, in that hurt. And as you open your eyes, I want you to look into the corner of the frame. And I want you to see your higher self there right now, watching what just took place. Tapping the little finger. And I want you to see your higher self with all of their compassion, with all of their love, with all of their wisdom, with all of their knowingness, with all their trust, with all their power, with all their beauty. And I want you to see them looking at you in that pain right now, recognizing what you just went through, that fucking sucked. And I want you to see your higher self right now walk over to that younger part of yourself, tapping the side of the hand. And I want you to feel them come close to you and wrap their arms around you right now. And I want you to feel their love holding you and protecting you and loving you and caring for you and keeping you safe and cherishing the gift that you are. And I want you to feel all of their love holding you in that moment right now. And I want you to feel that love come in and touch you so deeply that I've got you, I'm there, I'm with you, I'm here. Feel that right now. And take a big deep breath into that love right now. Allow yourself to receive the love. Take a big deep breath, release a big sigh. Ah. Tapping the top of the head. It's safe to receive this love right now. And feel into any part of you that doesn't want to let the love in right now, that doesn't want to say yes to letting the love in, that wants to protect against the love. And I want you to just feel into any resistance to fully letting go into the beauty of that love right now. Feel that right now. And then take a big, deep breath and release a big sigh. And as you hold yourself in that love right now, let's take a moment to be with that part of yourself. And I want you to see your higher self looking over at you right now with all of their loving gaze. And what do they want to say to you right now? What does your higher self want to say? As they look at you in that moment, what do they want to say? My higher self is telling me what? What is your higher self telling you? Take another big, deep breath into that message. Release a big sigh. Oh. And then go ahead and write the message into the chat area and then come back to tapping between the brows. What is the message from your higher self? Tapping the temples. My higher self is telling me what? What is your higher self telling you? Tapping the cheeks. My higher self is telling me I'm worthy of love. Tapping underneath the nose. My higher self is telling me come out of the trap. Tapping underneath the lips. My higher self is telling me I deserve love. My higher self is telling me I'm beautiful exactly as I am. Tapping the center of the chest.
Oh, I love you. Oh, I love you.
What is your higher self saying? Feel that message sink in right now.
Most of all. Oh, I love you. Oh,
allow it to soften into your being as you relax into receiving that right now. Take a big deep breath in, release a big sigh.
Oh,
tapping the front of the ribs. I can allow this in. I can move forward with this message. I can trust myself with this message. Or I can hold on to the resistance as long as I want. Let's take a moment right now and feel into any resistance to that message fully taking over your life, to that message dropping in deep. I'm clearing this for myself and my whole family line right now.
Forgiveness is a way to freedom.
Because we all want love.
Separateness is illusion.
Tune into anyone that you've been holding any againstness towards.
I'm talking about sacred giving.
Tune into any againstness to anyone in the past or to yourself in the past.
Grandmother, indigenous wisdom.
And let's choose right now to let it go.
Young and old, elders arising.
Let's choose right now to let it go.
We protect the wisdom tradition.
Take a big deep breath, release a big sigh. Tapping the ribs. I want you to feel into your life right now and the full letting go, whatever you need to let go of right now. What do you need to let go of right now? So you can be free. Take a big deep breath, release a big sigh. Hope is the choice that we make. I can be free now. As we change the world with intention. Tapping the side of the thumb, I'm ready to create what? What are you ready to create in your life? And I'm letting go of any resistance to this now. Let us run it free in our unity. And feel into any part right now, that any final strands that are still there saying, yeah, but I can't do that, or it's not the right time, or whatever excuse is there. You know you can hold us back. Tune into any final excuse right now. Feel that excuse, because that's all it is. Take a big deep breath into that. Hold it in all your compassion, all your love. Release a big sigh. I'm moving forward now. Tapping the next finger.
Let the tears become a river. Let the river go to sea. Let the waves carry us to shore. Let me all just run.
Take another big deep breath. Release a big sigh. Tapping the opposite side of the next finger. And now send love back to anyone in your family line right now who struggled with this as well. Send love back to any relationships you've had in the past where this was a dynamic. And just release it right now as you just send unconditional love that I am complete. I'm no longer carrying this with me. This stops here. I am finished. Thank you. God bless. Send it to anyone in your life right now. Thank you. God bless. We are complete. Take another big deep breath in. Release a big sigh. Tapping the little finger. I'm ready to move on now. Tapping the side of the hand. There's so much goodness waiting for me. So I want you to tell me, if this was no longer an issue for you, what would be happening in your life? Who would you get to be if this was no longer an issue? I would be, tell me what you would be doing. Tapping the top of the head. I would be, I want you to speak that out loud. What would you be doing? And who would you be? Tapping between the brows. And that's who I truly am. I would be, tell me what you would be doing. And imagine that right now, that you got to do that. Imagine that happening. Use your imagination right now. Close your eyes. See that happening for a moment. And how would that feel if you got to do that? Tell me the top three positive emotions that you would feel if you got to do that now. I would feel, tell me what that is. If I got to do what? Tapping the cheeks. And I want you to go deeper into that. What's happening in your life if you got to do that now? How are you showing up in your world? How are you showing up in your relationships? How does it feel in your life if you got to do that? Go on a little rant. Tell me the whole story. I would be, and I would be doing this, and it would feel like that. Tapping underneath the nose. And what would you be thinking about yourself and believing about yourself? I would be thinking that this is easy, or I've got this, or I'm worthy of love, or my needs do matter, or everything is happening effortlessly. I'm worthy of feeling good in my body. I'm worthy of feeling happy in my life. I'm worthy of, what are you worthy of? What would be those beliefs? I am worthy of. And it's possible that maybe I can create this now. Tapping the center of the chest, because I'm done with waiting. I'm done with believing that old story. Because that old story doesn't support who I truly am. And who I truly am is what? Tell me who you truly are. I am, tell me who you truly are. And that old story doesn't work anymore. Tapping the front of the ribs. I am, sing it to the ceiling, sing it to the universe. Let the whole world hear right now. What are you? Who are you truly? At the very depth of your core, at the most profound aspect of yourself, in your most lit up expression, in the very essence of who you truly are, the impulse of your light. Who are you? I am. Tapping the side of the ribs. I am. Tell me who you really are. Tapping the side of the wrist, and I'm ready to let that person out. Finger, I'm ready to be a shapeshifter. Tapping the next finger, I can create whoever I want to be. Tapping the opposite side of the next finger, and I choose what? What are you choosing right here, right now? What are you putting your stake in the ground about? What are you claiming to the whole universe right now? I am claiming what? Tell me what that is. I am claiming. Okay, I want to see a thumbs up if you're ready to claim it and really give it a shot. Are you ready to really just jump from one timeline into another timeline where a whole different reality exists? Will you shape shift like a chameleon into a whole new expression because you know you want to be that and you know that that's possible? Okay, so let's get the vision right now. Whole new timeline, whole new person, whole new destiny. I want you to really get detailed with it right now. Feel what that feels like. See who that is. And what are the thoughts going on inside that person's head? Tapping the little finger, I believe what? Tapping the side of the hand, I'm believing what? Tell me what you believe. And tell me, when you really let yourself believe that, what does that feel like in your body? What is the texture of it? Is it light? Is it bubbly? Is it soft? Is it pleasurable? Is it sweet? Is it delicious? What does that feel like in your physical body when you believe that? And I want you to magnify how good that feels right now in your body, because we are physical creatures and our pleasure is a sign that we are on the right track. Our disconnection from pleasure is a sign we have lost our way. So tune into how beautiful and delicious and pleasurable and happy and joyful and aligned and clear and exquisite that feels to believe that. All right, has everyone got the belief? Yeah? Tapping the top of the head. I want you to expand how good that feels in your body by 50%. Like, oh my God, I'm feeling my whole system light up. There's so much joy, there's happiness, there's this ecstatic feeling, there's peace, there's centeredness. Whatever it is for you, that feels really good when you believe that. And now expand how good that is in every cell of your being by 75%. Like, really let it take over. Like, whoa, it feels so good. Tapping the temples. And now expand it by 100%. Like, wow, I'm alive. Expand it. Expand it out. Expand all of that goodness out right now, like it is bursting out of your cells. Like it is bursting out of your being, that there is so much light coming out of you right now. And feel it just bursting into expression like a star being born. Feel that right now. Take a big, deep breath in to release a big sigh. Ah, tapping the cheeks. I'm bringing all of my light to this now. Tapping underneath the nose, and this can be really fun. So I want you to imagine all of that bright energy, all of that pleasure, all of that joy, all of that happiness, all of that peace, all of that grace, all of that ease. I want you to imagine your life now being blessed up by that energy that you are. Tapping underneath the lips, I want you to see it now touching your relationships and touching any situations that have had struggles. And I want you to feel that right now. And I want you to feel any struggle that you've been carrying with you. And I want you to see that struggle getting that light right now. Feel it. And then take a big, deep breath in, release a sigh. Ah. Beautiful. Tapping the center of the chest. I am free now. I'm relaxing into more of this goodness now. It is safe to relax into all of this goodness now. So tune into any part of you like, oh my God, who am I really? Can I really trust this? Tune into any nervousness around this new identity that's stepping in. And just hold it in presence and love right now. Hold it in peace. Take a big deep breath in, release a big sigh. Oh. I've got this. And I'm moving at my own pace. And I'm trusting the divine timing. I'm letting this be natural. I'm softening into my true essence. And feel all of that soften right now. Any hard edges, any resistance, anything that's finally there right now. Take a big deep breath into any final resistance. Lean into it. Pour all of your compassion right there, like water flowing into those areas right now, washing them away, softening them. Take a big deep breath into those places. Release a big sigh. Ha. I've got this. I'm creating what? What are you creating? Say it from your center of your chest. I'm creating. Because this is who I really am. And I love and deeply accept myself. And I'm a good human being. And I'm worthy of what? What are you worthy of? Take a big, deep breath in, release a big sigh. Ah, beautiful. Okay. Are you guys ready to do a little bit of laughter with me right now? As I mentioned at the start of the class, we're going to laugh for no goddamn reason. When we force ourselves to laugh, it produces the same chemicals in our brain that laughter actually creates. So if you find yourself getting self-conscious, just look at me and laugh at me or laugh at someone else. We're all looking weird, but we're just going to give ourselves permission to laugh. And if you need a little fuel to help you laugh, you might look at some of the weird ways that you used to be and just laugh at how comical it is so that you can help lighten up the topic, okay? So I'm going to give you all permission to unmute yourself right now. If you want to unmute your microphone, go ahead. All right. And we're going to start laughing on the count of three. All right. Oh, yes. I'm hearing some music already from laughter. Hey. And we're going to put a little soundtrack behind us. And let's begin. Held. Feel all of the energy waking up every cell, like light pouring in right now. Keep that breath held. Exhale, blow it out. We're going to do one more round of laughter. go ahead if you want to unmute and let's continue. Like you're holding a ball. Take a little bit more breath in, hold that. Imagine your whole ball around you filling up with light. Feel all the blessings coming in from the universe into your sphere right now, blessing your whole being. Exhale, blow it out. Rest your eyes for a moment. Just feel the space right now. Feel the magnificence of your life, your light, your power. Feel the intention of spirit, of God, of the universe that seeks to express through you in your life the joys and the gifts and the blessings that want to come through right here, right now. They are here, right now. Side of you. See those visions right now clearly in your mind. What are they? Paint them like a picture. And paint them with love and joy. Paint them with beauty. Paint them with love. See them in joy. See them in fun. Placing one hand on your heart, one hand on your belly. Just feel the message for yourself right now, what you get to take with you after this class. What is the message that your soul wants you to know is so simple and so easy for you right now? What is that message? Go ahead and write that message into the chat area. Waves are coming in. There is so much magnificence near the ocean. Waves are coming in. Writing your messages into the chat.
Near
Beautiful, beautiful messages. Beautiful messages. So I would love for you to write right now what the intensity level was with your struggle at the start of the night and what the intensity level of it is now. 10 being it was super triggered, 0 being you're now feeling free. So let me know what the number was and where you are now. Ah, Vinit, down to a 0, beautiful. Karen down to a 4, Sarah down to a 2, Rebecca down to a 0, Anne-Marie 4, Catherine 3, Emma 2, beautiful. 1, 2, 20 down to a 1, Anita, beautiful. 4 down to a 1, 7 down to a 2, beautiful. Amazing work, my friends. The power of our love heals us. When we make the time to love our fears, when we make the time to hold our fears in compassion, they melt out of our system. And we are relearning what our parents and what our culture forgot to teach us, because no one taught them. And so this practice is something that we can do consistently through our life. And the more we do it, the brighter we become. And so I'd love to open up the opportunity for anyone to share something that they discovered tonight about themselves, something that came through in the session. Perhaps it was a memory they realized, or perhaps it was a new belief that they discovered, or something that they learned about themselves or a situation. So if anyone would like to share, raise your hand. You can raise it in the video or you can raise it in next to your name. Okay, beautiful. Rebecca, sister. Gosh, I've missed you, girl. So nice to see you.
Hi, beautiful. Mwah.
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 Mwah, mwah, mwah. Yay, so how are you doing?
I'm wonderful. Oh, I'm so grateful I was able to be here. What came through was when I get confirmation now for myself, I'll get a vibration on the right side of my leg.
Wow.
So Jennifer, before I would get a vibration for my friends. And I'm like, I said it just one time though. I said, why? When am I going to get it for me? So the moment it came out of my mouth, I turned it around and I gave myself permission to say, it will come when it's ready. And so maybe a couple of months later, it started happening. But this time in tapping, it was the whole body.
Woo! That is amazing. Wow.
Yeah, thank you.
Wow, wow, wow. That's so beautiful, because I've been also really working with what a full body yes feels like. And so much of the time we're listening to the thoughts and emotional patterns that were programmed in from the past, and therefore we can't really hear what our intuition wants to say. And so slowing down and really listening to what a full body yes is. So perhaps for you, it's this full body vibration now that you're feeling. And I'm wondering what that vibration feels like. Does it feel like salt? What is the texture of that?
The texture is just like, it's not prickly. It's just, okay, I don't know. Like when I was on a motorcycle, it's like the whole body just vibrates. I mean, I was off a motorcycle already 2 hours. My body was still vibrating. So beautiful. It's just, and it just showers the whole cells. It's incredible.
Wow. Oh, that's
I
beautiful.
Love it.
Wow, honey. Powerful work. You can now take that into your whole decision-making process now. You're like, okay, am I getting a full body? Yes. Yes, I am. And actually, I had a great teacher tell me once, if you don't get a full body yes, then it's a no until it is a full body yes. And I think a lot of the time we like to second guess ourselves because other people think we should do things or other people's agendas are at play. But really allowing that practice to come into your life, like, and allowing yourself to learn what a full body yes is as well.
Yes,
you can
yes.
actually follow that. And at the start, like for you, for example, it's like I get it in my right leg. And now it's, you're feeling it in your whole body. And as you continue to practice to tune into that sensation, then that sensation comes more and you're able to listen to it more and it gets stronger. And then you have that real intuitive gauge that you can go to no matter what happens in your life. So that's so powerful. Awesome.
Yes. And I cried when we were asking ourselves, what is coming out? And it was just, you deserve to be a priority. And woo, I was just crying.
It's so beautiful that we can celebrate crying.
I love your tappings, and your tappings are powerful. It's just perhaps maybe the times that I've done them, I haven't tapped deeper more into myself. But especially during COVID, Jennifer, I have just been having such spiritual existentialism experiences. And it's just been, it's, COVID's been a blessing, and it's also had its, just to share one more thing with you, I am going to be passing my mother's ashes on Saturday.
Aww. And
my mind, my body is in peace. I miss her, but the way I miss her is different. Wow. I even during when we were doing the tapping, I was like, thank you, Lord, for showing me that I am really loved. And I'm not going to be alone.
Oh, wow. Some of the most powerful pieces that any human being could discover. And I think the death of a family member, especially a parent, really brings you up against that edge. And it really is so beautiful to feel you just really welcoming that in and recognizing that you are so deeply loved by all of creation.
Absolutely. By all of creation.
Yeah.
All of creation.
Beautiful. Thank you, Rebecca, for sharing. I'm so happy
to see you.
Love you too, darling. Awesome. Who else would like to share something that they discovered or something that came through in the session? Feel free to raise your hand in the video. Okay, Vineet. There you are, my friend. Hi,
Jennifer. Hi, everyone. Lots of love to you. I am Vineet. Actually, I'm from Delhi, New Delhi. And I have been known about you since you took session here with Living Consciously. And I was not there, but yes, definitely, I listened a lot about you, and I was very excited to join one of your sessions, and I got the opportunity to join here. I'm really, really, very glad to be here, and this has been really, very, really, you know, I can't put the emotions and word that how I'm feeling, as you know, it is all vibrations in my body. Even now, I am feeling vibrations in my hand, in my chest, in my head, everywhere it is a vibration. And I feel like, yes, I have done so much of injustice to myself by saying again and again and again and again in lots of years that you are one unworthy of love. And, you know, I don't know why I did that. But yes, it helped me a lot. And now I feel I am full of love and only love, love and light. And everyone is. And that is why I feel like, yes, I was practicing from a long time, seeing people, you know, just made up of heart and the love vibrating from them and seeing them, you know, full of love, and the universe is sending love to us. And don't give us food. We don't want food. We want only love. So I'm just going to do that. And I'm just going to ask for that and nothing else.
Wow. Bow to your feet, precious guru.
Thank you so much. And really, on 11th, I think we are going to have in the boot camp, if we have invited you. And again, we will have a session with you.
Oh, fantastic. I'm so excited. Yay.
I'm too much excited. Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you so much.
Such a blessing. Thank you, my brother.
Lots of love.
Lots of love to you too. I love that. Love is the deepest kind of nourishment we could get, more than food.
Yeah, absolutely.
Beautiful. Oh, yay. Awesome. All right, Karen, would you like to jump up?
Hi, how are you?
Good, my love. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Good to see you too.
Yeah, I'm struggling a little bit at the moment, so it was good to do it today. I was so close to putting my hand back down because I felt like mine was like, oh, they're so amazing, they've got all these amazing things, but then I was like, no, I'm pushing myself out of my comfort zone, so here I am. And I think my tap today, it kind of took me to a different area in my life compared to previous taps, where it's kind of been sort of, previous taps have kind of taken me back to the breakup of my parents, that sort of thing, whereas this one took me back to a time, it was a specific memory in college when I walked into a canteen where there were hundreds of people of the same age as me, but I always felt really like they were better than me, that they had so much more confidence than me. And it was something that I feel like I'd actually worked through, but realized today that actually I still have those feelings. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's kind of what I was working through. And it was just for me, no real vibrations or anything like that, but it was just a realization that actually things that I thought I'd already worked through are still there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so it was good to be able to work through that today.
So first of all, I just want to totally commend you on sharing and speaking out in a group and letting us know your vulnerabilities. I think that's part of the healing as well. So good for you for putting your hand up and letting yourself be seen in your vulnerability. Because I think so much of the time we hide our vulnerability because we think, oh, everyone's got it together. You know, yeah. You're scrolling on Instagram, everyone's got this like fabulous life on the surface. And the truth is we're all vulnerable deep inside, and we all have our up moments and we all have our low moments and everything in between. So just presencing what a gift it is that you shared and encouraging you to continue to share like that. And really recognizing that that's part of the healing. So I just really celebrate you for that. And you can come back to this practice over and over again. And a lot of the time, myself included, when I have had some pretty deep traumas that I've been healing or pretty deep thought patterns, sometimes you think you've got it cleared out. It's kind of like when you're not in a relationship, for example, you think that you've got relationship stuff figured out. And then you enter a relationship and you're like, holy shit, I don't have it figured out. All of my triggers are coming up, right? And so often the best place to test is to put ourselves right in it to see if we can remain neutral. And if we're not neutral, then it's like, great, there's my medicine right there. And I can just move at my own pace with it. I can take my time. Some of this stuff is ancient. And so it's not going to always clear out in one session, but the basic recipe of bringing love to whatever it is repetitively does start to peel off those layers by layers by layers. And when I started healing a lot of my sexual trauma stuff, there would be times where I was like, oh, I'm completely clear of the trauma. And I've done it. There's no resentment. I feel at peace. And then something would happen and it would be like triggered again, but triggered in a different way. And there's a different piece that needs to be looked at around it. And what I started to realize is like you'll have an issue and then you have many branches that come off this issue. So there might be thought forms, emotions, habits, belief systems, and all of those are connected to the one issue. And so you might clear off a couple of branches and think you're done, but there's these other branches still there that need love and attention. And so it's just recognizing that it's a continual process, but the more we do bring love, the more we create space for ourselves to just bring love to it. We know we're doing the right thing. And you showing up tonight, you sharing this and you being a part of this circle and you actively bringing love to it is part of your healing. So just love you, applaud you, grateful for you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
Beautiful. All right. So we have space for one more share. If anyone would like to share, you can raise your hand. Let me see. Have we got one more hand? Karen? Let's see. Karen, your hand is still up. All right. Anyone want to raise your hand for one final share? Nope. All right. Okay. Oh, okay. There we go. There's Kathy. She's coming on in. Hi, Kathy. Hi, sister.
I wasn't going to, but something did shift in me. And I just so often have this feeling of ungroundedness, mm-hmm. and like a ungrounded anxiety that gets pretty intense. Mm-hmm. And went back to a situation when my mom was sick and my dad was really worried and he wanted me to reassure him. And I was feeling very, very, very ungrounded.
I see.
And something shifted on that. Like I should have had support instead of having to support my dad.
Oh my God.
I should have been guided and protected and it just something lifted. I don't know. It was just in the rest of the tap, I didn't seem to worry about. I just let it go.
Wow.
It was cool.
Wow. Hearing that from you, Kathy, it feels like a big shift, because over the weeks and many, even months that we've been tapping together since last year, I know that you've been working on some of your relationship stuff with your partner. And I feel like that's such a beautiful piece around you really being on your own two feet, and you really being grounded, and you really being in a sovereign space within yourself to really then make choices for what really serves your life. So it's so beautiful to hear you sharing that today. And I'm really excited to see how that affects your life as you continue to move forward.
Thank you. I really wanted to say, I appreciate everybody sharing, and especially, I mean, I love the other two, but especially Karen's vulnerability. You know, but the other two were so uplifting.
It's beautiful. All is welcome here. Every kind of emotion is welcome. Every kind of experience is welcome. And that's what I love about this community, that it's all supported and that we all have permission to feel exactly what we're feeling. So thank you to that for everyone. And I'm going to invite everyone right now to take whatever it was that your message was and write it on a piece of paper and put it near your bed. And when you go to bed at night for the next week, I want you to read it and repeat it in your mind as you fall asleep. Because as you sleep, the subconscious flips into place. And it's the same subconscious that we're working on when we're tapping. All of the beliefs, patterns, emotions, all of the habits are tied into the subconscious. So read that as you go to sleep. And then the first thing as you wake up, read it as well. Several times you might repeat it out loud. And that's going to help this new pattern, this new wiring in your brain get set into your new way of being. And if you guys haven't joined our Facebook community, there's going to be an email that will go out on Friday. There'll be a replay to this video, along with an opportunity to join that Facebook community so that you can get updates around what's going on. We're going to do these live tapping experiences twice a month now, woo-hoo-hoo, with the whole community. So it's the second Wednesday and the fourth Wednesday of every month. So pop it on your calendar and let us know your thoughts. Feel free to email us. And I'm just so grateful to be in this community with you. It just really touches my heart so deeply. I'm so grateful for each and every one of you. And remember, just tell your friends, bring your family along. Everyone is welcome and invited. And we're just going to spread this around the world. So I'm sending my love to everyone. I hope you rest well. Whatever time zone you're in, some people are getting up in the morning. Some people are going to sleep. Some people it's 2 a.m. Wherever you are, thanks for showing up, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.